Chapter 8. A Miller-to-Be. The sun had set by the time dinner was served. A blustery wind howled outside the shaking house. Aragorn eyed Rorne closely and waited for the inevitable. Finally,
"I was offered a job in Tharinsfold Mill, which I planned to take."
Geralt finished his mouthful of food with deliberate slowness and laid down his fork. He leaned back in his chair, then interlaced his fingers behind his head and uttered one dry word.
"Why?"
Rorne explained while Aragorn absently picked at his food.
"I see,"
was Garrow's only comment. He fell silent and stared at the ceiling. No one moved as they awaited his response.
"Well, when do you leave?"
"What?"
asked Rorne. Garrow leaned forward with a twinkle in his eye.
"Did you think I would stop you? I had hoped you would marry soon. It will be good to see the family growing again. Katrina will be lucky to have you."
Astonishment raced over Rorne's face and settled into a relieved grin.
"So, when do you leave?"
Garrow asked. Rorne regained his voice.
"When Denton returns to get sockets for the mill."
Garrow nodded.
"And that will be in?"
2 weeks.
"Good. That will give us time to prepare. It'll be different to have the house to ourselves, but nothing goes amiss. It shouldn't be for too long."
He looked over the table and asked, "Aragorn, did you know of this?" He shrugged ruefully.
"Not until today. It's madness."
Garrow ran a hand over his face.
"It's life's natural course."
He pushed himself up in the chair.
"All will be fine. Time will settle everything. For now, let's clean the dishes."
Aragorn and Rorne went to help him in silence. The next few days were trying. Aragorn's temper was frayed. Except for curtly answering direct questions, he spoke with no one. There were small reminders everywhere that Rorne was leaving. Garrow making him pack, things missing from the wall, and a strange emptiness that filled the house. It was almost a week before he realized that distance had grown between Rorne and him. When they spoke, the words did not come easily, and their conversations were uncomfortable. Saphira was a balm for Aragorn's frustration. He could talk freely with her. His emotions were completely open to her mind, and she understood him better than anyone else. During the weeks before Rorin's departure, she went through another growth spurt. She gained 12 inches at the shoulder, which was now higher than Aragorn's. He found that the small hollow where her neck joined her shoulders was a perfect place to sit. He often rested there in the evenings and scratched her neck while explaining the meanings of different words. Soon, she understood everything he said and frequently commented on it. For Aragorn, this part of his life was delightful. Saphira was as real and complex as any person. Her personality was electric, and at times completely alien, yet they understood each other on a profound level. Her actions and thoughts constantly revealed new aspects of her character. Once she caught an eagle, and instead of eating it, she released it, saying,
"No hunter of the sky should end its day as prey. Better to die on the wing than pinned to the ground."
Aragorn's plan to let his family see Saphira was dispelled with Rorin's announcement, and Saphira's own cautionary words. She was reluctant to be seen, and he partly out of his own selfishness agreed. The moment her existence was divulged, he knew that shouts, accusations, and fear would be directed at him. So, he procrastinated. He told himself to wait for a sign that it was the right time. The night before Rorin was to leave, Aragorn went to talk with him. He stalked down the hallway to Rorin's open door, an oil lamp rested on a nightstand, painting the walls with a warm flickering light. The bedposts cast elongated shadows on empty shelves that rose high to the ceiling. Rorin, his eyes shaded and the back of his neck tense, was rolling blankets around his clothes and belongings. He paused, then picked up something from the pillow and bounced it in his hand. It was a polished rock that Aragorn had given him years ago. Rorin started to tuck it into the bundle, then stopped and set it on a shelf. A hard lump formed in Aragorn's throat, and he left.